In this video, we're going to show you how to set up your John Deere CP770 or CS770 for accurate data recording and illustrate basic navigation of the Gen 4 Command Center display. To start, from one of your run pages, navigate to the Setup button in the bottom left corner of your Gen 4 display. Start by selecting the client, farm, and field that represents where you are working in the field. The display will default to nearby fields, but you can select the View All button if you want to select a different field or create a new one. Correct naming structures here ensure that you will gather accurate data that can be used to make decisions from in the future. Under the Equipment section, you can review the serial number of your machine, GPS offsets, and header setup and configuration. Under the Header Settings button, you can configure certain row units to be disabled for documentation and notifications. For example, if you are harvesting in a single skip configuration, you can toggle off the required row units. Select Save to preserve your changes and continue. If you'd like to document the operator details, you can do so under the Details section. This ensures that when reviewing recorded work data in the Operation Center, the operator details will be recorded against the work completed. Next, select the variety you are harvesting. If you recorded your varieties correctly when planting, you can also send a variety locator map from your Operations Center organization, and the picker or stripper will automatically record the correct variety to align with what was planted. Next, select the desired harvest units of measurement and lint turnout percentage. Finally, the gin and producer ID fields can be filled in if desired. These details can be helpful if you deliver cotton to multiple gin locations and want to make it easy to identify and send the correct module data to the correct gin within Operation Center. Select OK to complete the work setup process. Back on the main guidance run page, select the guidance app from the shortcut bar and ensure that auto track is enabled. Then select the advanced settings button at the top, where you can turn auto track row sense on and off. Now, navigate back to the main guidance run page by closing the overlays, and you will now see a row sense status indicator in the bottom right of the screen. Pressing on this indicator gives you more information about the current status of row sense, and a diagnostic checklist, which will indicate if any prerequisites are not yet met for row sense to operate. Pressing the information button at the top of the page will give you more information about the row sense status icons and what they mean. Within the Row Sense Settings page, sensor offsets can be applied to optimize the machine's position within the row. And if you're experiencing undesirable guidance performance, it's recommended to complete a row sensor calibration, which can be done by selecting the Cal button at the bottom left and following the instructions. You're now ready to get harvesting. And with the Gen 4 display, there is a helpful set of default run pages configured to provide the key information you need to monitor the operation as it's happening. Use the arrows at the top right of the display to navigate between Overview, Harvesting, Work Monitor, Guidance, and Harvest ID Cotton Pro run pages. On the HID Cotton Pro run page, you can review the details for each bale that has been dropped and can add a custom note to the most recently dropped bale as required, such as torn wrap. All module data is documented in the display and automatically transferred wirelessly to your Operation Center organization, where you can view, analyze, and share the data. Watch our dedicated video for a step-by-step process on how to do this. You can also select the HID Cotton Pro app from the shortcut bar to get more detail about the module most recently dropped, including serial number, moisture, weight, and make any changes to notes about that module. If you need to manually export HID Cotton Pro data from the display, you can do so by inserting a USB drive and then navigating to Menu, System, File Manager, Export, Custom Export. Select Next and choose All Data. Select Next again and scroll down to select HID Cotton Pro data. Finally, select Next to complete the transfer to the USB. Returning back to the Harvesting Overview run page, you can review the progress towards building the current bale, including accumulator fill level and a visual of the current bale size in the Module section. The exact bale diameter is shown on the PDU display on the corner post. After pressing the auto button to eject the module, the bale is weighed on the module handler, with the weight displayed on the screen once confirmed. Finally, selecting on the module building area of the cotton harvester displayed on the screen presents the module builder options, where you can adjust the module size, compactor auger behavior, wrap portions, and the handler auto position. Thanks for watching, and be sure to check out our other how-to videos.